I'm going to be there. Ready, gas? Yeah, it's going.
Wow. Oh, you made that look easy.
Yeah,
that
was effortless. Effortless. So then, Joe, early part of the academic year, September to Christmas, all the learners at Tresham College are working with flat profile, yep, PVC, twin and CPC cables, mm-hmm, lighting circuits and socket circuits. We're using grey outer mechanical protection sheath cables. Mm-hmm. I see you haven't got the same your side.
No, over here we've got some white covered cables. So again, we're still looking at a similar type. So we've still got twin and CPC, and in this case we've got three core and CPC.
Okay.
But it's got this white sheath on the outside. And what does that white sheath tell us about this cable, guys?
It's an absolute nightmare to put in. That's what it tells us, doesn't it?
It's because a lot stiffer.
It's loads stiffer. Yep. And quite difficult to put the bends in that we, yep, actually put into the grey version of, yeah, the same cable.
Absolutely.
And there's a slightly different method when you're on site of actually making those bends. Yep. Something maybe our learners won't experience until they're actually on site.
Yep.
What's causing this to have such a different feel to it, Joe?
Well, the issue that we've got here, and this is a different kind of mechanical protection that's on, okay, the outside, and a different kind of insulation that is covering the conductors.
Okay.
The grey cable that you've got in front of you,
yep,
is insulated and sheathed with PVC,
okay,
which we're quite familiar with, we're, yep, quite happy with. And the designation for that type of cable is 6242YH for harmonised cable.
Good.
Whereas what we've got here is 6242B, okay, cable. And the last letter indicates the material that is acting as the insulation and or the sheath. So this is sheathed with some kind of low smoke and zero halogen material.
Okay.
Now what that means is, if we go back to our PVC cable,
yep,
if in a property, whether it be perhaps a residential property or whether it be perhaps a commercial property, yep, or something like that, if a fire breaks out and the PVC cables in that building start to burn,
okay,
it starts to give off a lot of black smoke, which can make exiting the building very difficult. And also that smoke is not good for you. It's bad for people to breathe in. And it also produces a type of halogen gas called hydrogen chloride.
Ooh.
So when chlorine is one of the halogen gases, and when it combines with the halogen in the cable, it makes this gas. Now the gas is very dangerous for humans to breathe in. And also, if it combines with moisture in the atmosphere, it actually creates hydrochloric acid.
Oh dear.
And that is really dangerous for people, buildings, property, the electronic equipment in the building. It's bad news. So in order to protect all of those things, some specifiers, some designers, some councils will have their buildings wired up with low smoke and zero halogen cable.
Okay.
Now, there's a small sticking point. You'll see an awful lot of cables with slight variations on that theme. So it might be LSOH, it might be LSNH, which is the one that Doncaster Cables uses that we'll talk about in a minute. You might see a few variations on that. The thing you've got to be really careful about is that there is a difference between LSF cable,
right,
which stands for low smoke and fume, and low smoke and zero halogen cable.
Okay.
So low smoke and fume cable is not strictly regulated and it can still give off dangerous gases.
It can.
Whereas low smoke, zero halogen cable has to meet very strict requirements for the emission of hydrogen chloride, that halogen gas, and the smoke that it emits. So don't be tricked into thinking that low smoke and fume is the same as or as safe as low smoke and zero halogen. It's not.
And that's what we've got in front of us. So we know the properties are very difficult for us to install,
yep,
exactly the same current carrying capacity, etc. However, putting bends in it, yep, is quite difficult. And the key to this video is actually removing, in this case, the white mechanical protection is, yep, a lot more difficult than what our learners have been experiencing these early weeks,
yep,
of removing the grey version.
Yep.
So Doncaster Cables, kindly, when we went up there and shot a video with eFix, and check out efix.co.uk for that video and article, allowed us to take away their cable of low smoke and no halogen.
Mm-hmm.
And we can see, Joe, that it's actually got a groove down the center.
Yep.
The one you've got there hasn't.
No, this is by a different manufacturer.
Okay.
No groove.
So what was the reason or thinking behind Doncaster Cables inserting this groove into the cable?
Well, it's a really smart idea because that groove is designed to help you run your knife down the cable,
okay,
in order to get the CPC out and then remove the rest of the mechanical sheath that's on the outside of there. So that's the idea behind that, and we're going to see if it makes installing, stripping this cable a little bit easier.
Okay.
Okay then, Gary, so we've got the cable on the bench in front of us. I can see you've got your stripping knife there ready to go, and we're going to try and strip this cable using the knife, using that groove that's been put into the cable there to to make it easier to strip. Just a point on safety. Obviously, we don't like moving a knife towards your body in case it slips off the cable and cuts into yourself. But Gary is standing with his body to the side of the knife as he draws it back. And so he's very, very safe while he's doing this. So do you want to demonstrate that for us, Gary?
Yeah. So we're going to run the blade down the groove, yep. And then we're going to see if it is easier to strip off. This is very difficult to strip off usually. Mm. So hopefully this groove is going to make it considerably easier. So I run my knife down the groove. Take my knife and move it round. Score round at the point of termination here. Take my side cutters. Let's cut into there. And hopefully, Joe, that's going to make it easier to pull away. Still difficult.
Yep.
But that has gone a lot easier. I'll show you the other one in a minute, original one. That was considerably easier to move that. It's not as easy as the standard PVC because of its properties, Joe.
Yep.
I've got a nice amount of French chalk in there.
Yep. Yep, come to expect that from Doncaster Cables, and we've been stripping those recently, that's all good. Yeah, so that was, again, from personal experience, I can tell you that that looked a lot easier than stripping normal low smoke, zero halogen cable.
Okay, I'll swap it in for the three core one we've got over there without the groove and just see if I can perhaps show goes. Physically it's a little bit more difficult.
Yep. I like that. Okay then, guys, so we've seen the grooved cable being stripped. Do you want to have a go at this more standard low smoke zero halogen cable for us?
Remember, we're using the technique that we expect our learners to. I know there's an industry, they tend to pull the CPC through. Yep. We don't do that, so before you comment, I'm just doing the same technique we ask our learners to. Yep. I've scored round here for terminating point, actually the point of which we're going to remove off the mechanical protection, so I'm going to use exactly the same technique again. I'm going to go in with my side cutters, like so, and hopefully I can pull this apart. So easy, it's just sliding down there.
Yeah. And of course you could have run your knife down.
I could run down.
Or even score it like we did before, but there's no indication that you might not be cutting into a live conductor there. You might have some serious issue there, whereas the groove in the other one just made sure that you kept just on the CPC track effectively.
And again, I like that technique, and it was one I was trained with, but again, with our students coming straight from school, we try and avoid them running a knife down because you damage the cable. So I think I've got it going now. I'm going to be there. Ready, Gaz? Yeah, it's going.
Wow. Oh, you made that look easy.
Yeah,
that was brilliant.
Effortless. There is other techniques, we know that, but this is the one our learners would use. Wow, that is really, and it's really difficult to pull off.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, no sweat.
Well, I think we can say that was a very conclusive demonstration, wasn't it? I think it's fair to say that having that groove in the cable really does make life a little bit easier.
We hope this video has been some help.
A little fist bump there as well.